channel, do y'all creators out there ever have days where you're filling your makeup and you want to do a video, but you really don't have an idea, but if you do have an idea, it's something that's going to take some research, or, you know, certain camera angles and lighting and all that, you don't feel like doing all that, but you want to do a video anyway, plus you're in a good mood and you just want to talk to people. Well, I had that feeling today, and I decided to go ahead and do something I saw Christian Game do. Oh my God, my hair is going to be going everywhere. Please ignore it. I still haven't cut it. I'm sorry. I had it up in a nice bun, but this is telling me a little, you know, something that happened. I was drinking coffee earlier. It spilled a little bit over here, so I'm covering it up. Hey, I'm being truthful with you. But anyway, I decided I wanted to do this tag. It has no questions. What it is packaging that caught your interest and lured you in, or, you know, if you work, you want to buy it anyway, but the packaging is just a bonus. But I saw Christian Game do this, and I've seen a few other people do it. She was the first one. She's a YouTuber I've been subscribed to probably 3 or 4 years now. She's my age. She does a lot of informative videos, reviews of a high-end drugstore. She's really funny, really just, she's so cool. Check her out if you haven't seen any of her videos. Check her out. You'll probably like her. I really do like her. But let's go ahead and get started. Let's get started. Y'all do see this brush set back here, and this drew me in. This was a Christmas a few years back. Actually, this was with the rose gold set, which is this set here. The purple was the one before, and it's got the straight black one, I think. But I put the purple ones in there because I used some of the rose gold today. You know, this is the powder brush. I love these. These are super soft. I got them for like $5. They were like $20, so I got them at Christmas time. But let's see here. Did I grab everything? Am I missing something? I think I'm missing something, guys. Oh, no, it's behind me. I told you I've had one of those days. Let's grab this here. Okay, I dropped something. Yes, I did. Sorry about that, guys. I tried to film this 5 times now, so I had something like a plane going overhead. You couldn't hear me. All kinds of stuff happened. These are just lip balms that I got found at like Dollar Tree or Family Dollar. Let's get started with the one that I have in my hand here. There was 4, but I gave one to a friend. These are crayon. Actually, I got these at Walmart. They were the Christmas stocking stuffers. They're so cute. I had to have them. They're cute. And these you see in my background. These are the LA Colors Balm Besties. You got the little raccoon here. You got a little kitty cat. And then you got a smaller little kitty cat here. Love them. And I'm not going to tell you what my husband thinks this looks like. Put down below if you can figure out what my husband's dirty mind thinks that looks like. Oh, and I want to apologize for my eye being red. I'm well aware it's bright red. I'm sorry if it's annoying y'all. But I was driving today and something flew in the window and hit me in the eye, and I cannot get the redness to go away. I can see everything. I'm fine. It didn't hurt my eye. But it's just irritating right now. No matter how many redness drops I put in, it's not helping. These, I think I may have got at Big Lots. They're lip balms. They have it on the bottom. It's got a little monkey. I got 2 little owls, a little teal one and a little purple one. And then you got a little piggy here. So cute. And then I got these two nail polishes because they look like skulls. I tried using them, but they had like formaldehyde or something. They literally will give you the worst migraine you've ever had in your entire life. Even we both could not stand them. Let's go to this. These are the gifts that you'll see sometimes at Walgreens during Christmas time. They always do the Disney. This is the Disney villains. This is the brush that I did film. I've never taken them out, never used them because I didn't want to mess them up. And I got, okay, what did I do? I got this in here. Sorry, I'm going to do this. This is the Disney Good and Evil eyeshadow. I did try to use this, but the quality of it was not great at all. I usually have a dip in there. That was about the only one that was any good. And then this one here. But the quality wasn't that good. Thank goodness my air conditioner just cut off. And it had some nail polishes that went with it. Just love the packaging. I just think the packaging is so pretty. Nail polishes weren't half bad, especially the purple. But I really don't use them because I just like, you know, I like the packaging on it. So, and this is the Cinderella Glass Slipper lip glosses. Got the glass slipper on it, and this is the first thing I saw and drew me in. This is the a dream come true highlighter and blush and bronzer set, and you have a brush in there, and the brush is pretty soft and it has a slip on it. I did swatch it, it's really pretty, but I decided not to use it because I just liked how it looked, and I didn't know how to destroy it. And my husband will see this behind me displayed, because I have to have them over there now, and he's like, why don't you use those? And I'm like, because I'm like how they look, and I don't want to mess them up, they're just collector pieces. And he just rolls his eyes at me and goes, as long as you didn't spend a lot of money. I said, no, they were 50% off $4.99. Of course, my friend bought me this. I think it was like $12 for that set. Oh, and this went with the tube. I do actually use this, because using this doesn't mess up the outside, how it looks. This is one of their clean highlighters. Really pretty highlighter. I wasn't going to use it at first, but I saw somebody else that I wanted to use it, and it was really pretty, and she really liked it. Here's some hard candy stuff that I really like. Got this at Christmas time. It's the ombre nail set, and I do use these. I haven't used them in a while. I just like the glitter on top. I got a little tin over here. Let me get that out of my way there. And this is also from Hard Candy. It's a Christmas set. I just love the outside glitter on it. Let's see, is there any more? I know there's another Hard Candy in here. There's a couple back there. This is brand new. This is the Sheer Envy Coconut Water Primer Stick. I am wearing this today. The packaging is really what drew me in. I didn't know what it was until I got up to it and discovered it was something I could really use, and I'm really, really liking it. But definitely, I just love the color, and it just drew me in. And I do like the packaging on their regular eyeshadow palettes. This is It's Raining Men. Yeah, I love this palette. I just love the outside packaging on it. I think it's really, really pretty. And let's move on to some skincare. Kristen talked about how some of the functionality of it, and that's how some of these are for me. The packaging is pretty on the Skaderm Shifted Retinol Complex, but what I like about it is it's got a real heavy weight to it. I just like how it opens, and I think it's pretty to me. And this is one of those functionality things. This is the Radiance Carday Luxe Radiance Eye Cream, but you can use it all over your face. It's real pretty, the writing on it's really, really pretty. But what I like about these is these types of pumps, and I have a few, and I've had a few others that I've used up that are done like that, and I really, really like them. And y'all know this is new to my collection. It's the L'Oreal Hydrogenous. It's a glass bottle. It's moisturizer. But I like the pump on it, and I just love the teal color to it. And it's got a hefty weight to it. This looks real pretty sitting on your counter. Okay, let's just start grabbing stuff. I do really like the Wrap Tantalizer packaging. I just love the color on it. This was just up front at Ulta. Y'all know I just use that side because that's too much for me. But I just thought it was pretty. Plus, I've been on highlighters. Let's do some MAC stuff. These I've had forever. Don't use anymore. But I did use the crap out of them. This was the MAC Delights collection. I think they had a couple different palettes. I just love the original look of it. And this is soft. You can tell I did use it quite a bit. But I don't use them anymore because they are quite old. This one's pretty old. This is the MAC Jewels palette. I got it for the packaging, and I got it because it had honey lust in it, and it had parrot. I love parrot, but you can see I barely used that. I used everything else in here. I think that's mulch right here, and I'm not sure what the other ones are, but I really liked it. I used the crap out of it. And this blush here is the Sakura blush. I got it because I did like the color, but I really liked that it had the heart in the center. I thought that was really pretty. It's a really pretty blush. I really like it. And they don't even make these type pop lip conditioners anymore. The Tendon Lip Conditioner with SPF 15 has a little fishy on it. Just had to have it. I know I did. Now, is that it on my MAC stuff? It isn't. Oh. And I did want to make a comment about their lipsticks. I love, it's iconic. Everybody knows a MAC lipstick bullet. And it's iconic. Everybody knows it. I love it. And another lipstick bullet that I like is the Marc Jacobs. This is just a little birthday gift. I just love how these look. It only goes on one way, so you can't mess it up, or you could. And another hard candy that I like. I just got this. Yes, I got it for the color, but the packaging is to die for, in my opinion. Okay, and you'll know that I also love the e.l.f. Aqualine packaging. I just think it is so pretty, because I also got over here the E.L.F. Aqua Primer Mist. I just think the bottle is pretty. It's really, really pretty in my opinion. And also pretty is the LA Girl Glaze Lip Paint. like how they designed those. Oh, and this came in a, I almost forgot about this, in an Ipsy bag, or a Birchbox one. I think it might have been Birchbox. It's a snail cream. It's a little snail. No, I haven't used it yet. I'm still afraid to use it. Just snail cream, people. Okay? Snail cream. And here's some more of the LA Color stuff. This is the Youth Bomb. I had a lot of these. Some of them went bad, or I either used them all up. Like, I still got some all over my house. And, of course, I have quite a few of the, I have one of the matte palette lip glosses from LA Colors, and I have quite a few of these, the lip glosses, the regular ones. I just love these. They're such pretty colors, and they last a good, decent amount of time. I just really, really like them. Sorry, I'm trying to get stuff out of my way here. And here's something else. I remember when I first got a Tristique lip color in my bag, I thought it was open because of how they do it. This is just really cute. I really like it. This is the Maldives highlighter, which is my base of my highlighter today. I just thought it was really, really cute how they do it. Here's another matte thing. I almost totally forgot about this. This is the Heatherette. They were a designing duo in the 90s, I think. And this is the Style Minx lip glass. I had to order this sucker. I wanted it so bad. I just thought it was so pretty. And I also like the fact that the CoverGirl lip lavas. Oh, it is hair everywhere. Nothing new there. My hair gets everywhere. I just love the packaging. I think it's so pretty. It's eye-catching. And also, this is what drew me into the Wet n Wild gel line, because I saw these and it kind of drew me in. This is the Pout and Love, and this is the Love lip balm. It just drew me in, and then I got the lip liner and fell in love with it. Y'all know I love that lip liner. Let's see. Okay. Trying to get some stuff. Got some balm stuff in here. I'm trying to get out so I can do it all together. And I know a lot of people don't like Jeffree Star. You know, you like him, you don't like him, whatever. But I do like his packaging. His packaging is really cool. And this is I'm Nude, his liquid lipstick and I'm Nude. His packaging is cool. I love watching his videos with Laura Lee. They're hilarious together. And you know, when her and Manny get together too, they're hilarious. And Physician's Formula, I got this because it was on sale for one. It was like 50% off, I think. Yeah, I mainly got it for the quilted pattern on the blush. It's a pretty blush. It just doesn't last on the skin that long, to be honest with you. So I don't tend to wear it that often. And y'all know I just got this too. This is the Wet n Wild Mega Cushion Color Corrector. This is the green one, Great Redness, and I am wearing this today. I just love it. I was going to get the New Hard Candy Color Corrector, but I saw this, and the packaging is really what drew me on that one. So I can't admit the packaging got me on that one. Is that it in there? Yes, that is. Let's move on to here. Put that on the way, I'm going to get down. This is the lip gloss I had on today. Raised on Good Corals. I had a nail polish, but it was horrible, and I got rid of it. That was with this line. But this, I mean, come on, this says pop on it. It has the cartoon strip or comic book type writing on it. So I definitely had to have it. And I probably will never wear these lashes. And this is before I started wearing lashes, and I bought this. So you know it was just the packaging. It's In the Mood for Maude. I mean, I might. If I do a character for Halloween or something, I might. I don't know. We'll have to see. I might. Like I said, we'll have to see. And let's go on to the balm. The balm has iconic packaging. It's retro. I mean, so many people love it. This is the new tube. It's the back. And then you open it up and you have the ladies on it. And the dude has guys on it. I just love how, love it. It's got that retro feel, and that's what I really love about it. And then there's the Meet Matrimony. Front and back. I just love the retro feel of it. And I do have two singles from the Meet Matrimony, and they look like these here. But I just grabbed these real quick. This is the Bahama Mama bronzer. That's what that looks like. I just love the packaging on these. And they're, it's just so darling. And here's one from the Nude Dude. What is this in? Flirty. So you got the guy on it there. I just love it. That retro feel. And of course, the Mary Lou Man. Mary Lou Man, or however the heck you say that. This is my one I've never touched, but I just love it. I think it's so pretty. Is that it on the bomb? Yep, that's it. And this, you know, I love getting the Ulta gift sets, but I really loved the design on this one. And I especially love that they did this here. They put this Hello Beautiful thing in here to separate the eyeshadow from the face products. I really liked that. I thought that was really neat. And y'all know that I just got some new Makeup Revolution stuff. And I told you my one complaint about them. Did I tell you? I can't remember now. I think I did. My one complaint about them is they don't put their design that's on the outside Unicarton, which is a technical term for it, the cardboard packaging for it. They don't put it on the actual palette itself. And this would have been gorgeous. I mean, I don't mind keeping the cardboard packaging. Some people don't like to, but I do. I mean, look at that. That would have been gorgeous on the actual eyeshadow palette. And that's the end of Orange Unite, and this is the brand new one I got, which I know I am in love with this thing. I also got the Strobe palette, which I'm having to keep myself from using because I got that Maldives cream highlighter in my new Project Pen, and I got to use that. I'm trying not to use that one. I'm trying not to. I won't do, but I might mix it with that one. You know, I can do that. But this is the Welcome to the Pleasure Dome. That is gorgeous. That is like my favorite. Out of all of these, I think this is my favorite right here. I just love the corset, and it just, it's gorgeous in the color. I love it. And of course, it's the back, but the eyeshadows themselves, I'm loving this palette. Loving that palette. Okay, I think that is it, guys. I told you about the brushes. Let's go on to what is on my face today. I showed you some of the stuff that's on my face. Let's see here. I'm just going to reach in here. Of course, you know the Trace Deek. My Maybelline Rewind is, of course, my concealer of choice lately. And on my face, I did a mixture of my Rimmel 25-Hour Lasting Finish, along with my Aqua Tinted BB Cream. And the reason it says 17 on here is I just put it in my Finish 17 by June 17th, my birthday. And I did have the Neutrogena one in there because it was not applying to my face right. It was really splotchy, and it just didn't look right. So I went ahead and had to take it out and put it in my empties. So I added this one in instead and mixed it with this, which is more full coverage to make it not as much full coverage. And this is still good, so it worked fine. And, of course, my NYX Wonder Stick for my contour. And for my blush, my base and my blush is my Seraphine Guava Butter and Pure Guava. And my eyeliner is my e.l.f. eyeliner. Y'all know I love that thing. It's about on its last leg, I think, though. And on my lips today, I have my Almay. This is number 30, Nude Light. This is underneath the, nude, I think. Lip gloss. They're pretty much the same color. I love these. Janae sent a few of these to me. I love them. I want to get some more of them. My mascara is a mixture of my Maybelline Colossal Big Shot and my Ulta Legendary Lynx. And I do like the packaging on this, the gold and the purple, because it reminds me of Mardi Gras and LSU Tigers. I'm from Louisiana, so of course I'm going to like it. And on my eyes today, I have a mixture of my MAC Bitter Eyeshadow, and that's on the outside. And this is the Maybelline The Brights. I got this in green mixed with the bitter, and then I have the gold on the inside, and the white is highlighting. And on the rest of my face, I have, for my blush, let me open this without breaking it. What is the name of this? My Rendezvous, my Ofra Rendezvous blush. And in my crease, I have my Urban Decay Fireball eyeshadow that's in my crease. And what color is this? You Do You. And of course, my highlighter is my Ofra You Do You highlighter. You know how much I love this highlighter. I love it so much. Oh, and I did mix, I think the name of this company is Doucet. It's D-O-U-C-C-E with a posture or something over it. I mixed that with the Rendezvous blush to make it not as dark, because it is kind of dark, and you gotta use a light hand with it. But that's what's on my face today, and that's the packaging that, you know, lured me in, pretty much. But, if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below, or you can email me, and if you'd like to do this video, I'd love to see y'all do it. If there's any videos or challenges or tags that you'd like to see me do, put them down below, because I'm thinking about doing a video every day in June, since it is my birthday month. If y'all are interested in that, let me know. If not, let me know. But if you would like to see it, you know, give me ideas for videos. I do have quite a few, but just give me ideas for videos. But I think that's it for now. I love y'all, and I'll talk to y'all later.